From the moment you got out of the car and I saw your gorgeous hazel eyes peeking over your black mask, under which I could already tell you were smiling, this feeling of peace and calmness fell over me. But when I saw that smile, your little gunshot wound as you call it, I knew in my heart that you were something special. We talked for countless hours, each passing so seamlessly, and this crazy feeling building inside as we talked about everything. Our goals, our families, our morals, our wants and desires in a partner and in life. Each piece fitting so perfectly into the last. You are the one, Ferris. It's so cliche, but I just know it. You are my forever. I've told you that I pulled over to the side of the road after our first date because I knew that I loved you that night, and I just needed a minute to sit and take it all in. But the truth is, I also wrote down those last lines to you in my phone because I knew that I would be standing here in front of you today. Everything fell into place that night, and for the first time, I could see what the rest of my life truly looked like. And then a couple weeks later, I met Stella. And even though I had to bribe her to like me that night with a ball, it was just one more piece that I never realized was missing. Being her dad, being your boyfriend, fiance, and now husband has been the biggest honor in my life, and I will never understand how I got so lucky. The way that you love is so rare. In a world crowded by fake portrayals of happiness and love, finding your genuine heart and compassion has been a blessing. You've become my home. Walking through the door after work to you and Stella is the best feeling in the world. Knowing that it's more than just a house, it's a place that contains our love. It's the normal nights, when we work out together, cook dinner, settle in on the couch to watch Jersey Shore or The Challenge or whatever show Uncle Paul's told us to watch recently, that I just look at you and I fall deeper in love with you. I love how you make me feel like myself, which is something that I hadn't felt for a very long time. You listen to me without judgment. You make me feel heard, wanted, appreciated, and cared for every single day. I love the way your eyes light up when you play with any of the kids in your life, and that little laugh that you do when you think that I can't hear you. You're the funniest person I've ever met. I love sitting with you and watching TikToks, and sometimes you just bust out these little one-liners and we just laugh until we cry. I love the way you always look at restaurant menus ahead of time and have become quite the Yelper lately.
Pro tip.
Yep. And your uncanny ability to always know what's going to happen in every show or movie that we watch. I swear that you're psychic sometimes and it kind of scares me. I love you because you are you. And I told you that once and you told me that it was a cop-out answer. And in a way, I can understand why you think that. But the truth is, you are my picture-perfect definition of love. I could not draw up something more perfect than you. I mean, you truly are the explanation of what love really means. You're unapologetically you, and that's all I could ever want. Today, I promise to always support you, to be your safe place, your peace, and your home. I promise to always be open about feelings, wants, needs, worries, fears, and loves, and I promise to always listen to yours, to work together as a team at whatever life throws at us. I promise to choose you, to choose us, every single day, in this incredible love that we have for one another. I promise to always date you and prioritize our time together. I promise to always support our family and show our future kids the same love that we show each other. I promise to work on not interrupting you and to talk quieter when it's just you and me sitting in the same room. I promise to never stop rubbing your head, your back, and your feet, and to never, ever stop laughing with you. But most of all, I promise to never stop updating these vows to you. Just as we continue to grow together, so should the promises that we keep. I can't promise you that every day will be easy. I can't promise you that there won't be rain. But I can promise you that I will be standing there right next to you in the rain, looking for the blue skies. The people, places, and situations around us will continue to change and challenge us. But if we always come back to that Sawa parking lot, falling in love all over again, I know that we'll make it. I still get that same feeling of knowing without a doubt, that undeniable instant connection, that sense of everything is going to be okay whenever I'm next to you. In those moments, I see a future like I've never seen before. I see a family to come home to, a love to come home to every single day, a love that we will continue to build and pass on as we grow together, as we create a family to fill with love and show them just how powerful and amazing it is to find your true partner. I see a porch swing, you and I at 80 years old, sitting next to each other old and gray, saying we made it. Thank you for choosing me, for accepting me, for loving me. I have never once doubted us or this crazy journey that we've been on together. We've grown stronger, we've grown together, and we've never worried about us. I love you, Ferris. Let's do forever.
Craig.
Sick.
You got this.
Our love story is my favorite. Today, standing here in my favorite place in the world, surrounded by our friends and family, I feel complete. Like for the first time in my entire life, everything makes sense. I am where I belong, standing next to you. I feel so lucky to be marrying my best friend today. I will admit, as a little girl, I never dreamed about all the details that go into this day. In fact, I'm pretty sure everybody here knows that I have not cared for this process much. The flowers, how the napkins should be folded, the centerpieces, the signs, the stress, all the things that come with a wedding. Because those things will be gone when we wake up tomorrow. To me, they just don't matter in the end. What I did dream about when it came to today was everything my husband would be. I dreamed about what you did for work, how many kids you wanted, if you would fit into my crazy family, if I would fit into yours, what your dreams and goals were. I dreamed about a partner I would build a solid foundation with, one that I would make lifelong memories with, who I would fight for and raise children with. A husband I can laugh and love throughout our entire lives together. And you, Craig, are more than I ever could have dreamed of for myself.
You stop. You
calmly and peacefully slipped into my life at a time I truly never expected you to. You filled in all the holes in my heart that I never thought I would be lucky enough to fill. You truly love me for all the good and all the bad that I am. You have become my home and my safe place. Going to sleep on December 12, 2020, I had absolutely no concept of what was in store for my life the next day, or how it would drastically change just 24 hours later in a Shrewsbury parking lot. I knew the first hour of our first date that that would be the last drink I ever had with a stranger. Sitting at that bar that night, I felt like I had known you my entire life. From the minute we met, I was never worried about us. For somebody that worries about legit everything, that's a big deal. I knew instantly how this story would end. Everyone thought I was crazy, but I just knew in that moment that I had met my soulmate. I don't think I ever really prepared myself for that day. It was this unforced, calm, easy moment that swept over me like nothing I had ever experienced before. I truly believe there is only one soulmate for everyone, and I am so confident that I have found mine in you. Our love is unlike anything that I have ever come across in my lifetime. I am convinced that this love was handpicked specifically for only you and I to experience. Our love knows kindness, respect, patience, and forgiveness. It knows no bounds. It knows that communication and teamwork are so important. Our love knows how to support one another through bad days at work, or had hard grad school classes, or powerlifting competitions, or even COVID not once but twice. Our love allows us to unapologetically be ourselves. It allows us to grow independently and as a couple simultaneously. Our love knows how important the little things are, like remembering each other's coffee orders. Our love knows that laughing together watching TikToks late at night is just the best. It knows that Friday night dates to Grafton Grill for fried Brussels sprouts and Sunday morning coffee runs to LCB with Stella cure just about everything. This love knows that setting alarms for the newest Delani or story drop is very important. This love knows that any day at York Beach is our best day. Today I vow first and foremost change your name in my phone from Craig Bumble to just Craig. I needed that.
Okay. I did too.
I vow to never give up on us and fight every day for this beautiful life that we have created. I vow to remember today and the promises that we're making to one another, especially when life gets hard. I vow to be the best mother to our future children. Don't worry. That I know how to be. I vow to love you through our weakest and strongest moments. I vow to never let you face a day alone and to always have your best interests at heart. I vow to you a love that's willing to make sacrifices, a love that will meet you halfway, and that's faithful. I vow to forgive you and understand that you're going to make mistakes, but when you do, I will hope you learn from them. I vow to always appreciate you and say thank you when you do the smallest of things that take up the biggest spaces in my heart. I vow to be a love that's your best friend, your loudest laugh, your biggest smile, your happiest memories. I vow to choose you on our good days, but especially on our bad ones. I love you with all my heart and promise today that I always will.
Oh, yeah. We got a good thing, babe. Whenever life is hard, we'll never lose our way, 'cause we both know who we are. Who knows about tomorrow? We don't know what's in the stars. I just know I'll always follow the light in your heart. I'm not worried about us, and I've never been. We know how the story ends. We will never break.
Having pledged your love and promise to one another today in front of all of your friends and family, and by the power vested in me by the state of Maine, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
What?
Greg, you may now kiss your bride.
It's more than a good sensation, it's more than a passing fling. You are the explanation of what love really means. It's bigger than you and me, it's 1 + 1 = 3. When we talk about forever, then forever's what we mean. So I'm not worried about us, and I've never been. No matter what may come our way, we will never break, we will never break. Build on a foundation stronger than the pain. We will never break. As the water rises and the mountains shake, our love will remain. We will never.
You know, as parents, we cherish our children equally. They each have unique gifts, talents, foibles, and quirks. And we're not supposed to have favorites. But I can say regarding Ferris that I have known her the longest. And based on that longer view, I can say with great confidence that I have never seen her happier than since when she met Craig.
Cannot change. We will never break. We will never break. Build on a foundation strong enough to stay. We will never break. As the water rises and the mountains shake, our love will remain. We will never, no, no.
chasing flame. You are the explanation of what love.